Hello, everybody. How are you doing this evening? Welcome to the stream. I'm Heavenly Hedgehog, and today we are going to play To the Moon. This is a gift from the wonderful Vertosa. Thank you so much, Vertosa. You are awesome. You make me so happy. And now we get to play a game that everyone tells me is amazing.
What?
Well, see, I already have it running, and then I just stopped.
Wow, yeah, the game's really loud.
Okay. I thought it might be. I turned it way down, too. Check in a minute. Hopefully it's better now.
That's a little bit better.
Alright, it's going to...
I would still go...
a bit lower.
Just a little bit lower. It's not bad at the moment.
I've changed it.
Okay, I'll find out.
See if that works. Hold on, everyone.
I think that's a good volume.
Okay, awesome. You can actually hear me now? Is that you're saying?
I could generally hear you, but now I can hear you much better than I could before.
Alright, paraphrasing, I'm Heavenly Hedgehog, this is To the Moon.
Do you want that window taken care of?
If you feel like it.
What?
If you feel like it. And this lovely game was a gift from the amazing Bartosa. Again, thank you. Alright, so I have tissues here at the ready because
is that better?
I have heard this game is most definitely going to make me cry. That is better, thank you.
Okay, it was looking a little bright in my neck.
It was quite bright. I was just going to say screw it, I don't care, but thank you.
That is a very you thing to do.
I know.
You're
all
fine.
Right. Nope, I did not see that one. Begin! I wonder if there's settings. I don't know. So all I know about this game is that everyone thinks it's good and that it is... I know the basic premise of the game. Which is, as far as I know, two doctors going through the memories of a dying man to fulfill his last wish. Oh, I got a fuzzy on my nose. It tickles. I like that we've been hearing piano music and there's a little girl playing the piano. And then a car crash. Alright, I'm going to assume you guys don't need me to read for you. Heroically evading the squirrel. Squirrel! You ran over it anyways. Ah, I still killed the squirrel! Hi, Bartosa! Thank you again for the game. How are you doing this evening?
Sorry,
was
that too loud?
Yes.
Coming out of my headset.
Yes, the puppy cam is back, and so are puppy treats. Yep. Puppies, you fighting? You battling?
They are battling. Okay,
Sky, I need your vote. Bartosa, I need your vote too. Should I read the dialogue?
Yeah.
Okay, that's one vote for yes. Bartosa, what's your vote? I know I have to wait for the stream delay. Alright. I'm going to assume that Bartosa will say yes. Alright. You ran over it and hit a tree. I don't promise to do voices. Look, don't worry. It's a company car. Are you kidding me? The boss is going to kill us. We'll just say I was saving a puppy. He likes puppies, right? Alright, Martosa has voted to read. He's more of a cat person. Why does the world have to be so complicated? Fine, whatever furball he fancies, crisis averted. Good, go write that on your report later. Let's grab the equipment from the car and move already. Received equipment. Got the sucker. Let's roll. Right click to toggle a menu. Characters. Dr. Neil Watts, Technician Specialist, Sigmund Kor. Dr. Eva Rosaline, Senior Memory Transversal Agent from Sigmund Corp. We have equipment. Looks like we're supposed to go up. Hey, wait, don't forget the car. Just wanted to see if you'd remember. How thoughtful of you. Can I not go this way? It looks like no, I can't go this way. Let's read the sign! Wiles household ahead. Putting up a sign when they live in the middle of nowhere is like asking to be robbed. The sign to the house points the other way. Oh, how kind of it to exist. Seriously, I just went this way! Oh, those are stairs. Ah ha ha ha. How am I getting around here? I'm not as how. Oh, those are stairs again. I am bad at getting stairs from pixels. Who put a boulder here? Maybe it's their security system. Cucumbers. We don't have time for this fluff. Let's try pushing it out of the way. Maybe we could find a tree branch and jack it with... Wait. Or we could just call it a night and blame it on that. Push by hand. On three. 1, 2, 3. Well, this G's super strong. I don't even... What was that? Not a boulder, that's for sure. We need to get going for now. We'll figure that thing out later. Right. Squirrels! Up we go. All right, we've reached the house. Ma, they're here. Any pixels. Not a bad place to retire at, huh? I could do better. Night shifts. Love them or hate them. You know the answer, you stupid owl. It's probably gonna be an all-nighter, you know. I know. And I doubt they'd have any coffee. Shut up. And the ocean waves will sing lullabies. Not through your blathering, they won't. And your eyelids will. Thankfully, the door opens. Don't forget the equipment, moron. I don't get paid enough for this. No one ever gets paid enough for whatever they do. Nobody. I never told anyone, but I've always thought they were lighthouses. Act 1. Dr. Watts and Dr. Rosaline, I presume. Thanks for coming on such short notice. That's okay. I tend to be bad at predicting deaths as well. Are you the patient's daughter? Oh no, I'm just his caretaker. And these are my children, Sarah and Tommy. It's not exactly a 9-to-5 job, so Johnny lets us live here. I suppose this Johnny is our man? Johnny? Listen, if it's a kid we're dealing with, I don't think we're the ones you want. No, no. He just prefers to be called that. He's upstairs right now with his medical doctor. Come with me.
Don't forget the equipment.
Come on, grab that case and let's go. When my back breaks one day, I'll sue you with the insurance claim. Alright, let's head upstairs before I drop this. Stairs. Can I explore? Four River by Johnny Wiles. What kind of a song is this? It's just two notes repeated over and over. For the most part, I know nothing about music, though. What's through here? The patient is waiting upstairs. Better not waste time. All right. There. I'll get the hang of the clicking, I promise. Okay, they're gone. Whoever gets there first gets to play the melody. You pushed me! Did not! Whatever, you get the boring two notes anyway. This is more than two notes. I know that much. Kids are pretty good for their age. Hey, you're the one who said there was no time to waste. And incidentally, I'm the one who is carrying the weight of a small meteoroid. Yeah, come on. Ready to set up? Look around. Gee, you know, I think I'd like to carry this excruciatingly heavy object around some more. Thanks for asking, though. He's unresponsive at this point. By the looks of things, he's still consciously hanging on. It's hard to say how long you'll have, but I would hurry. I want to see the pictures. What's through here? Bathroom. Alright, nothing to explore in here. Let's leave the bathroom. Alright, let's get set up. Yes, it'll just be a moment.
You guys, I'm blocking all the credits for you. I'm sorry.
Alright. Are you sure a common household power outlet is sufficient? No worries, we're the experts. Oh crap. Standard procedures, just keeping you on your toes.
That's exactly what people want to hear on a deathbed.
How's he doing? Not so well. If I were to say, he's got just a day or two left. That's plenty of time. So you two can grant him any wish, huh? To try, at least. But we always succeed, because we're awesome. That's the spirit. So, what's the wish?
The moon.
The moon?
The moon. He wants to go to the moon.
The geezers just keep on getting crazier, huh?
So, can you do it?
It depends. She meant to say yes. Why don't you tell us about our client here?
That, I don't really know much. Johnny's an odd man. Through the 2 years that I've worked here, he rarely spoke. He worked as a craftsman for most of his life, and his wife passed away 2 years ago. I don't really know many details.
I have a feeling I should have taken a look at all these pictures.
I would have known more if I were his paperboy, for Pete's sake. Shush, just do your thing.
Well, I suppose if you look around the house, you may find some more info. I suppose Johnny wouldn't mind since he signed for you two.
So be it. All right, which one of us plays detective?
I think Dr. Rosaline, because Dr. Watts is kind of a jerk.
Thanks for the offer, but I'm busy leaving a butt print on this chair.
Right, do continue.
Tommy and Sarah can show you around. They're probably at the piano downstairs.
Alright. Selections of readings from medical journals.
We're exploring.
If you think there's something I've missed, let me know.
Save.
Right now, I would like to take a look at this. A painting of a lighthouse by the cliffside. A painting of a woman holding something yellow and blue. A painting of an animal of some sort. A casual painting of three people.
Glad you agree with me, Bart.
Wait, come back here for a moment. I have something for you. I got the voice wrong. Oh well. I never said I was good at voices. Here, take this. Received remote patient monitor. That'll keep you updated on Johnny's status. Thanks, I was just going to ask for it. Johnny's heart monitor is now activated in menu.
Hey, Michelle.
Hi.
What time are you going to want dinner?
Nine-ish?
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 Okay.
Alright, so we've got a heart rate monitor. That's going to stress me out later. Alright, so not much time has passed since the last time I looked at a clock. And this looks like a little doghouse, I think. Let's see what's down here. Got trash. We're in the kitchen! Alright. Nothing to see in the kitchen. There was a candy can, though. Hello, small children. What you want? Show me around the house. Sarah and Tommy, right? Your mother said to ask you two to show me around the house. Okay, maybe we will. Maybe? I think we just need a little convincing, that's all. What do you think, Tommy? Yeah. What would you like? We want $1 trillion. Or the candy cane mom hides from us. Yeah, or that. Huh? There's a giant candy cane on top of a high shelf that we can't reach, which I just saw. It's in the kitchen. Ma put it there to save for when we do chores. Get it for us and we'll give you a tour through the house. What do you say? Well, sure, I'll go get it for you. My mother used to keep candies on high shelves, too. All right, I'll go get it. The kitchen door's right next to the stairs. Now go! Go, my adult peon. Yes. You, my minion. Eh, not my kids. They can have all the candy they want. There's that candy cane. Can I push a chair? Can I push a stool? Yes, I can. Might as well get that candy cane for them while I'm here. Alright, get on the stool and get the candy cane. Alright, receive candy cane. Terrible calories. Yeah, well, that's not why you eat candy now, is it? I was in the dark. Alright, I got your candy, kids. I like the music. Okay, got what you wanted. Good old candy cane. If you come and give me your tour at this instant, I won't sneeze on it. Okay, where do we start? I know! There's this funny room in the basement. I don't like that funny room. What do you mean by funny room? You'll see! It's weird. We need to get the keys, though. The old man hid it inside a book in the study. Well, I believe the study is over here. I mean, I think this is the study. Tommy doesn't like turtles. Sarah, aspiring professional ice cream taster, aiming for the top. That's funny. Alright, there's no books here. I don't think this is the study. Can I see any of these pictures? No. Let's find the study. I found a bathroom. Yes! I don't know why that was an option, but sure, let's do it. I found the study. This is the book room! The key to the funny room is in the thickest book on the upper shelf. Let's turn on some lights. Can't see anything here. Seemed he liked to paint. Dusklight, the tale of a girl who fell in love with a zombie who emitted the smell of daisies when showered with gentle sunlight. Read passage. Maybe another year. Received room key. He chose its hiding spot well. The Pilgrim's Guide to Origami, Volume 1, The Key to Avoiding Paper Cuts.
The Pilgrim's Guide to Origami has already supplanted the Great Wikipedia Origamia as the standard repository of all knowledge and wisdom about paper folding. For though it has many omissions and contains much that is apocryphal, or at least wildly inaccurate, it scores over the older, more pedestrian work in two important respects. First, it is made of paper, and secondly, it provides numerous band-aids to make up for the inevitable paper cuts resulting from the reading of this book. Yes! For the Grand Origami Master, it is absolutely essential for each origami to be completed in exactly 42 moves. In most origami tournaments, scissor cuts are considered cheating, but uppercuts are deemed legal. Was there more? Yes. No, is there even more? No, there wasn't. Okay. Alright, I have a key. Let's talk to the children again. Tommy used to throw books at me and call it a book fight. Until one day I threw one back and needed a band-aid. That's how things go with kids, right? Everything's fine until someone does it to you. We can open the funny room in the basement now! Well, this is the basement. We play hide and seek here. Turn on the light before you trip over something. Alright, we got books. A dusty pile of Animorphs books! Oh my god, that brings back memories. You remember Animorphs.
Yeah, I loved Animorphs. Animorphs were awesome.
Animorphs was awesome. I never finished the series. So there's a locked chest. We used to find all kinds of cool junks here. Moldy books, moldy buckets, moldy cheese, you name it. As long as it's moldy, I guess. Door's locked. Open door with room key. Let's finish exploring. No! Damn it. This way. What's down here? The chest is locked. Box is filled with colored papers. Cabinet fills with unused fine china. Dusty books. Let's talk to the little girl. Once we were down here and the lights were out and Tommy fell down those stairs. He chipped a tooth, but that's okay because he's ugly to begin with. Oh, these children. So delightful. It's like a cave in here. Wah! Origami bunnies everywhere! A stuffed toy platypus. It looks adorable enough to annoy Neil. Might come in handy. Poke it! Sit it up. Take it. A broken music box. I wonder if that plays what they're playing on the piano. The rabbits make me nervous. I can't go anywhere. Alright, so I have a room key for the basement door, a toy platypus, and a patient monitor. He seems to be doing fine. Save! What happens if I turn out the lights? They move? Did you see it? What do you two know about all those rabbits? Nothing! The old man didn't want anyone to go inside, so we never told him. There are more of them, actually. Where? Yeah, those rabbits are kind of creepy. inside the abandoned lighthouse. It's just beneath the cliff.
It's turning into a horror game.
Want to go see? I have the keys. You aren't supposed to go in there either, are you? Remind me never to take you to Neil's house. So, you want to go see the lighthouse? Well, it's rather cold outside, but... Let's go see the lighthouse! You know what? Fine. Maybe it'll tell me more about those rabbits. God, I hope nobody dies. Let's go check that old lighthouse out.
Anything in here that I can see? Not really, no. Alright, well, I guess let's head outside. So this is Four River. I hope I'm not expected to remember that tune, because I will not. Okay, so there's the lighthouse. Somehow I need to get over there.
There it is! We need to head south to the street and take the other path to get down it, though. Down to it, though. Yeah, I forgot my parachute. Oh, my.
Alright, I'm exploring at night outside with two children who aren't mine. Who I just met. This seems totally legit. Alright. I am the best doctor ever, is what I'm saying.
It's here!
Huh?
My novelty beach ball! I thought I lost it!
Ah.
It's stupid anyway. Oh, I'll never lose it again! I'm gonna hide it! Don't look!
There's no time to waste.
Okay, done!
Okay, let's just hurry to that lighthouse. Odd child.
It's smoking! Who's the dummy that crashed the car?
Not me. It's pretty dark out. Aren't you kids scared?
Of course not. We roleplay it away.
There we go.
What? Tommy's a super powerful knight and I'm a mighty magician. Yeah, we destroy all evil.
Oh, that's nice.
Do you roleplay too?
No?
She's not cool enough to do it.
Hey, I could if I wanted to.
Just you children watch.
I'm getting egged on by children. Best adult ever.
Ooh, a squirrel!
A squirrel's about to get taken away by a seagull? Poke the squirrel.
Oh no, it's a terrible squirrel gun!
Don't worry, children, I'll protect you! What is happening?
Attack!
Shoot.
Loudest! Your time is at an end, squirrel gun! Yeah! Stop it, or we'll tell Ma you animal abuse! Yeah, she'll call the cops on you!
What? I wasn't gonna... Didn't you say you like role-playing?
You should be ashamed of yourself. Let's name it Teddy! Okay!
Let's just forget this happened. It's because I picked the shoe, isn't it? Am I supposed to be exploring more? Just going to the lighthouse. So we've got a bunch of little folded rabbits. We have a stuffed platypus. A musical score. Several paintings, likely painted by him. In memory of River E. Wiles. And so the score was for his wife as well. River Wiles. Was she John's wife?
Dunno. Come on, the lighthouse is right there.
Duh, more creepy bunnies.
This is it!
A multicolored paper rabbit.
Hey, this wasn't here when we came last week. Oh yeah, Johnny must have come here before he fell ill again.
This is the only one with two colors, huh? You know, these things actually look pretty hard to fold. Kind of an odd hobby, though. Oh, it's my phone. It's Watts. Is everything ready? All right, I'll be right there.
Why do you have a creepy ringtone?
Because it scares the monsters away. Come on, let's head back.
Receive Paper Rabbit. No! No!
I didn't click on the other thing yet. Oh, why don't you be late by another half an hour? Not like we got a dying client or anything. I got caught up in something.
I got caught up in something, too. It's called our job.
Get off your high horse. I'm late just this one time, and you milk it. At least tell me we're good to go.
Of course we are, because I'm competent.
Your helmet's on the couch. Chop, chop. There's a couch. Oh, here. Not yet. Let's talk to you. By the way, I'm curious. How does it work? Do you just write him another life, like a novel?
No, we can't just make up new memories out of thin air.
Then how do you do it?
Not us. The machine does most of it.
Oh, this is Watts. Naturally, since we aren't paid enough to get our hands dirty.
In a nutshell, we simply travel through his memories to as early as possible. When we do, we would then transfer his registered desire of going to the moon to the reconstruction of the world and himself at the early state. And with the help of a Wikidata on his own, the machine would simulate a rerun. Except this time, he'll have the motivation of his registered desire with him all his life. So you'd be depending on him fulfilling his own wish by simply having the desire to? How could that be? Everyone has ambition for things, but most don't accomplish them. That's because in the real world, ambitions fluctuate and fade. People start things with a passion, but eventually they lose that initial drive and slow down. But imagine if you locked onto that initial push through your entire life, never wavering. It's more powerful than it seems. That being said, no ambition's gonna help a dead man. We'd better go get started.
Oh, of course. Sorry. Go on. I'll watch over his physical conditions through the procedure.
This guy must be rich.
All right, here we go. So we go to the beginning, huh? This should be the last accessible memory. Disable speech for all except Johnny.
Done. Let's get him.
At any time, you can view your position in time by moving the mouse toward the top of the screen. Okay. So right now we're here. So, where is he? The paintings are all blank. So it looks like I can't go downstairs right now. Would he be this way? Found him. I found someone. Johnny? What a pleasant surprise. We don't get many visitors around here. My name is Dr. Eva Rosaline, and this is Dr. Van Matterhorn. Dr. Lorenzo Von Matterhorn. God, he's a dick. Dr. Neil Watts. Are you familiar with the Sigmund Agency of Life Generation? Oh, are you two from the agency? How convenient. I've just been thinking of calling you. Lily, get us some tea, please. Lily? Actually, you've already called us. We're here to fulfill our contract from the relative future. Careful there. Careful there. If you slip off the cliff, we're going to have to reload this memory. Watch it, Neil. Show some respect. It's just a program, you know. I know, but this is his last accessible memory, and we need its cooperation. Worst comes to worst, we can just reboot it. Why would you waste time like that? Gosh, this guy's a jerk. You... You are here to take me to the moon, aren't you? Yes, John. I suppose I had a good run. Not good enough, it seems. So, can you do it? Can you take me to the moon? We can't, but you might be able to. Why do you want to go there? I don't know. It's fine. You can tell us. It's essential for helping us get you to go there. Do you want the fame? The money? You've got to have a motive. I'm sorry, but I really don't know. I just... do. I can already tell this is going to be a pain in the ass. Nevertheless, Johnny, here's what we will do. We need to get to your childhood, but it is too distant to do so in one memory hop. Thus, we will need to traverse through your memories with a gradual backward leaps, which you've given us permission to do in the relative future. Once we lay down the waypoints in your childhood memories for direct access, we will return here. That's when you'll need to help us influence the childhood you to become an astronaut. Or to get on a giant catapult. The point is, you'll need to have more to say than just, I don't know. As long as you can take me to the moon, I will cooperate in any way possible. Good. Now, in order to leap to a memory, we need an item that is of importance to you. Do you have a memento of some sort to get us started? It's the rabbit. That'll do. Well, shall we? Ladies first. Received note, moon. We'll need to prepare this memento first. We have a note. Descriptive. Objective. The moon in Johnny's memory is full.
Let's go. Complete the memento. Click the orbs to flip pieces. Memento can now be activated for transversal. Let's activate the memento. Wait, what about my privacy? We'll try not to violate what we can avoid. But in most cases, it can't be helped. You know, if you wanted your privacy to be utterly respected, you probably shouldn't have asked people to go into your mind. There's rabbits everywhere. Creepy, creepy rabbits! Turn off visibility and interactivity. It'd be messy to be seen. Yeah, yeah. Happy? Jeez, what's with all these rabbits?
That's what I want to know.
This is creeping me out. We probably should have checked his record for psychopathy first. What the? Did he hear me? That's impossible. It's probably just a part of his memory. Then I stand by my point. Anyway, quit blabbering and find a memento here to hop from. Imagine we're gonna go for the platypus. Well, aren't you special? Having two colors and all your siblings look like they're drowned in bleach. What's that? You think you're really creepy? Why, yes, I agree! What's with all the rabbits? Why am I moving so fast? So we have anything in here? What's with the umbrella? So that's what we're trying to activate then. An old and patched up backpack. What is this, a million years old? Guess we'll find out. A selection of readings from medical journals. The Emperor's New Clothes by Hans Christian Andersen. A glass bottle of pickled olives. I hate this stuff. What's to hate? It's pickled olive. Exactly. Fresh wildflowers. Alright, so I've missed one. Don't. If I have to explain our presence to him at every memory, I'd go crazy. Don't tempt me. What have I missed? Was it really not the backpack? How is it not the backpack? The clock is moving but soundless. Clocks in Johnny's house never tick. Wonder if they don't move then? Hadouken! What the fuck was that? What? That's it. I'm doing the breaking from now on. prepare.
Okay. Bad at these kinds of puzzles. But I did it! Yeah! All right. How do I travel with the umbrella man? Activate. Now where are we going? So we're still way up here when he's very old. When it comes to rain, though, through is better than onto. I don't mind it regardless. Seems like these memory hops only span a short period of time. We need to find a leaping memento or it's going to take forever. Meh, just enjoy the scenery. It's gotta be that platypus. Man, he was two? Good platypus. Honestly, I just don't think this animal has the right to exist. The world's not big enough for two of you. In memory of River E. Wiles. It's finished, River. Like you, I'll be able to watch over her every day. She won't be alone anymore. I might never understand why, but I stayed true to your wish. I'm sure Anya is grateful to you too. But when I'm gone, who is going to watch over us? Who are you? My name is Eva. I was just passing by. Was she your wife? Yes, her name was River. That's a special name. It didn't need to happen. She didn't need to do it. But she... You wouldn't understand. I don't even understand. Did his wife commit suicide? Or did she die protecting someone? Note, Anya. Someone John and River cared for. Oh good, I just keep going. I thought I was an amazing clicker last time. About time you got here. I almost thought you fell off the cliff. What were you doing? Enjoying the scenery. What else? Any luck here? Big luck. Huge. Dinosauric. Huh. This place looks pretty empty. It's a lighthouse. What do you expect? Anyway, I'll catch you on the other side. Have fun re-breaking the barrier for yourself. Broken lighthouse lamp. Hmm. prepare the memento.
Well, like I'm going to get the ideal. Oh, this was far more than I thought it was going to be. I got the ideal!
I surprised myself. Activate. We're still only taking very short leaps. Just enough. After we pay for your operation, we'll have just enough left for it, so don't you worry. White lie. That's what you call it, right? No, I'm sure we can just... Stop it. I don't like it when you lie. I calculated our finances. I know how it's like. Why do you try to convince me against my will? We need the money for your medical bills, River. I understand that Anya means a lot to you, but this is just too much. I mean, she isn't even... Do you know what makes me happy, Johnny? What? Do you? Well, I do. I just hope you can help me with it. River. When the papers for my treatments get here, I will not sign them. What you do with our money is up to you. But if you would grant my wish, I want you to use it to finish building that house. And then, for every day that you live there, I want you to watch over her. Visit her, speak to her, comfort her. I don't want her to be alone anymore. And what about you? Happy. I'll be happy. Bart! I'm gonna need tissues soon if this keeps up. Johnny? Yes? I made this. Tell me what it is. What? Just tell me what it is. It's a rabbit, like all the others you made. What else? Or, what else? It's made of paper. What else? Its body is yellow and the rest is blue. Good. What else? Look, River. I wrote a song. It's for you. Okay. Well, would you like to hear it?
Yes.
You didn't have to bring the piano in here for this. I can hear you just fine with the door open. I just realized I can hear a heartbeat. I might have it too low for you to hear it, but I can hear it. It's called For River. Why so cliche? It's just a placeholder. Who is this Anya they were talking about? If she's so important, shouldn't we have seen her in his late memories? I guess he didn't keep that promise after all. Unless...
Unless what? Never mind. Hey, that's the same song the kids were playing earlier, huh? I guess he taught them. You know what? I'm too manly for this. I'm heading on. I already got my memory links. You want to hitch a quick ride to look around or look around yourself? Stay and explore. Go on ahead. I'll catch up with you. Don't you miss the days when memory audio to MP8 conversion was legal? I think I brought home over 2,000 songs during my first year on this job. Note, Paper Rabbit. What River gave to John. The Emperor's New Clothes by Hans Christian Andersen. Note for River. A song Johnny wrote for his deceased wife. Its title is a placeholder. Go exploring. So this is a different house than the one that we started in. A pot of mixed dough. Someone's making bread, maybe? Glass bottle of pickled olives. Someone really likes these. Nicholas, I'm telling you, there's just no way. What if we take it apart? Look at us, John. We aren't exactly at the ripe age of piano moving. You know what? If this means that much to you, I'll pay for the professionals to do this. I can't help saving that house for you. So this is the least I can do. So I'm assuming that their child, that Anya is their child and that she died young. In that house, or at least somewhere in on those grounds. And part of why it's so important to River is because that's her child's resting place. That's my theory right now. You don't need to confirm or deny. What am I doing? There we go. Just over double the ideal. All right, let's head out. We're still moving in tiny, tiny hops. Finally. Look what we have here.
Hmm.
bet they saw this cliff and thought it was not dangerous enough without people living on it. Well, clearly Anya is very important. Nick called and said I should come. I don't think we've met Isabel yet. I brought you pickled olives. They're your favorite, right? I heard about River. Will she be okay? Her illness was just diagnosed in its late stage. Fortunately, it's treatable. But the medical bills... We can't afford to finish building this house, Isabel. We can barely afford to pay for her treatment. I'm just relieved that she'll be okay, but... You don't know how much this place means to her. She's going to be heartbroken. I'd help, but Ted and I have been barely getting by since the market crashed. What are you going to do now? I'm going to tell her that we can make it. I'm going to tell her that we can afford everything. I don't want her to do anything crazy. You shouldn't lie to her. You don't understand, Isabel. If she found out, I'm not sure which she'd choose. So what? If she chooses not to save herself for the sake of this place, then so be it. It's what she really wants. I really dislike when you neurotypicals think you know what's best for others. I hate when you call me that, Izzy. Do you think this is all about her? What about me, Isabel? After all these years, am I not allowed to be selfish even once? I don't want to be alone, Isabel. I'm not going to let her die. That's arrogant. I don't care. Where are you going? Going to pick something from this cliff to bring it back to her. It'll at least give her some comfort. That doesn't make what you're doing any less wrong. Nick wanted me to give you this. He said it's called Everything's All Right. It isn't. Sky.
Huh?
I'm too emotional for this.
Oh.
Oh, the pickle jar is the memento. It was the track! Exploring. Okay. Alright, so it looks like I can't go farther south. I wonder if I can hop the stream here. Nope. Alright, so everything I've missed has to be up here somewhere. Got it. All right. Let's get these olives. Prepare the memento. There we go. Received note, pickled olives. Activate. I'll look at the note in a minute. So you guys are really going for it, huh? Yep. The construction's starting in just a few months. It's a bit of a squeeze. We had to split the payment. But with financing, we'll make do. How wonderful, having your dream house built in such a beautiful site. You had your wedding at that lighthouse near there all those years ago, didn't you? That's not all that's special about it. We have a long history with that place. Well, it's good to have some good news at a get-together for once. Cheers and congratulations, you two. Yay, cheers. Be right back. I'm gonna get some fresh air. Me too. Well, buddy, it's sure been a while. Hasn't it? Who knew how hard it is to get across a few cities nowadays? That river, still so quiet, huh? She's actually been talkative at home, and with Isabel. I guess she's just not used to you. So I'm the bad guy here, huh? Oh, hey! So did you tell River that thing from back then?
I did.
So how'd she take it? For the most part, she took it well. But something bugs me. Ever since the incident, she's been making these strange rabbits out of paper.
Origami rabbits?
Yes, lots of them. I used to fold origami animals for my daughter all the time. What's wrong with that?
I don't think it's the same thing.
She's been doing nothing but making the same rabbits day in and day out. Our house is literally filled with them now. Didn't Isabel say that something like that is a common trait with River's condition?
Yes, but something doesn't feel right this time.
When I ask her about it, she never answers. Instead, she gets this distant look in her eyes. It's almost as if she wants something from me. And the strange thing is, I feel like there's something I owe her, too.
Have you asked Isabel?
Yes, she said she talked to her about it, but got nothing.
Well, I'm certainly not one to inquire, but I'll tell you this. I've known you since middle school, and you're notorious for overthinking. You're probably just imagining things. There's no need to get too worked up. Usually when someone says that, something's always wrong. But I'll give you the benefit of the doubt. You're probably right. Probably. I'm always right, John. So there was an incident, likely involving Anya. Wait, so even he himself never knew what was up with those rabbits? Forget about the stupid rabbits. We've got bigger problems. It's a confined memory, and there are no mementos anywhere. Don't worry, we can probably draw one out from him. How? Leave it to me. I just gotta give the bartender a quick visit first. Alright. Pickled olives. Johnny's favorite. Nope. I'm used to right-clicking on things. Hey there! Can I get you anything? Heyo! Can I get a bottle of pickled olives, please? Sure. Cash or credit? Check. I'm sorry. We don't take checks. Oh. Just put it on my tab, then. Wait. Does that mean you don't have any money? You're so getting resetted. Hey there! Can I get you anything? Hello! Can I get a bottle of pickled olives, please? Sure, cash or credit. Just put it on my tab. I feel like spending big today. Oh, thank you, sir. Here are your pickled olives. Thanks, bro. You'll be getting an enormous amount of tips today. Thank you, sir. You're such an ass, Neil. Oh, loosen up. Why, is that a bottle of pickled olives you're sporting? Yeah, are you a fellow olive lover? Indeed I am. Just got a fresh bottle of them myself, in fact. Mind if I join you? Sure, why don't you grab a seat? We'll down a bottle together. Oh, yeah, that sounds just swell. Eva, disable taste simulation now! Oh, Neil, I don't think I feel like it. I'm so gonna get you back for this. So that's how we got our first toaster. You okay there? Yes, I'm just savoring the amazingness of pickled olives. They're wonderful, aren't they? Yeah, I just can't understand how anyone could find such things to be disgusting. Take your time. We've got 2 bottles left. So I said, hey, that's not right. And they totally agreed. These sound like the most boring stories ever. And you know what else is wrong with society today? Yeah, I actually have it right here. Why? May I see it? Okay. Here it is. And freeze! Finally! Dear Lord! How are the olives, Neil? Oh, shut your mouth. Wait. Don't you dare. Don't worry, sheesh. See, I'm doing it by the books. Hulk smash! Neil, seriously. I'm trying to get into this and you're ruining the mood. Totally worth it. Let's prepare the memento. All right.
Oh. Ha ha ha. I couldn't tell that some of them were filled in because it's a piece of paper and it's white. Oh my goodness. Activate. Although I don't know what that paper was. Oh, they're much younger this time. Well, relatively. Relatively speaking. Their hair is no longer silvery. Craggy nutcrackers! You aren't Australian. Who cares? We're like 20 billion nanometers off the ground and standing on a damn flagpole! Just jump down. It's not like you can be hurt here. Are you kidding me? It's a friggin' skydive! You can't stay on here. You can't get off. God, I hate it when this happens. I swear, if this place... Eva! What the fuck? Wuss. Where did he end up? There he is. Why would they abandon her like this? Is Anya the lighthouse? Did they name the lighthouse Anya? I suppose she's just no longer needed. No longer needed? By ships, I mean. You know how it is. Now that everything has GPS and all that. Look, River. This place means a lot to me, too, and I've been thinking. In our current state, things have been pretty stable. If we save well, in a few years, we could afford to build a house on top of here. It's going to be squeezed, but we'd be able to see her from the window. In the morning, at night, we'd always be nearby. And we could walk here anytime. She'll never be alone again, John. I'll be able to watch over her every day. Yeah, we will. Good for them. You gotta be kidding me. You remember what happens, don't you? It's like watching a train wreck. The ending isn't any more important than any of the moments leading to it. The important thing is that over here, they're happy. Let's move on. It's a lighthouse named Anya for some reason. Wait a minute. They were referring to the lighthouse as Anya, weren't they? I suppose so. Then that river. She declined treatment for the sake of a lighthouse? Isn't that a bit too extreme? I've seen stranger things in the course of the job. Me too, but I can never wrap my head around it. It's none of our business anyway. She's not our client. Anya, the abandoned lighthouse by the cliffside. Alright, I kinda gotta agree with the jackass here about declining treatment for the sake of a lonely lighthouse. This better be a super special lighthouse. Anything for me to click on here? Okay. Oh, follow them. So what I haven't found yet is the memento. There's nothing over this way. So it has to be something by them, right? Find me your memento. Where is this memento? Can't go more that way. I mean, to me, right now, at this point in the story, it would make more sense if it was where a kid passed away. But she named a lighthouse. I guess it's just a bigger scale of naming your childhood toys? Kind of along the lines of that, but the me right now doesn't get it. Oh my god, where's this memento? Nothing is standing out as momentous. Is it a view? Is the memento a view? From the road. Was there a rabbit by the road? Oh. You're right! Thank you! I did not even see that. Let's prepare it. All right. So if we do maybe that. Ah, ha, ha, ha.
activated. River? You're still moving in teeny tiny steps. A yellow paper rabbit. Dear Lord, not again. Nope. Nope. New boxes of plain paper. Uh-oh. I think I know where this is going. Old baby grand piano. How the heck did they move this thing upstairs? Who knows, but I bet it'd be a piece of cake for the TARDIS. Not really. You can't even get it through its door. True. Well, that settles it. Moving pianos is a pain in the arse for everybody. It'd probably take an entire episode to get it inside. I wouldn't mind seeing such an episode. Me neither. Sounds pretty epic. Let's keep exploring. I got to the ideal again! Oh, she's already going nuts with the rabbits. You went out for a haircut this early in the morning? What are you making there? Rabbits? Did you see the rabbit I left for you? Yeah. Tell me about that rabbit. Huh? Describe the rabbit. It was yellow. What else? We've been here before. A bit puffy. And? Well, it's just a paper rabbit. I don't know how else to describe it. You're acting strange, River. Is something wrong? River? I don't know about you, but I'm starting to get some inverse deja vu. I think I know of her condition, but it's rather odd even for... This is rather odd even for that. You think she's... Do you? Perhaps. Who knows? But like you said, she's not our client. Let's just get what we're paid for over with. Many long strands of orange hair. So this is the day she started it, huh? I don't know what's wrong with River. I'm assuming we'll find out, right? Not quite ideal that time. Activate the memento.
Exploring first, looking for rabbits. Alright, nothing down here then, I think. Can I go this way at all, or just go up the stairs? I think I have to just go up the stairs. Oh, good, so we do find out what's wrong with her. It's gonna be quite rude of the game if they didn't tell us. This is where the house used to be, isn't it? The house that never should have been. I mean, really, what is it about unusually high and dangerous places that attract people? Note, acrophobia. Something that Johnny and River apparently don't have. I guess this is where all those logs came from, huh? Is that why you approached me back then? Yeah. What about now? I suppose it's just a part of it. Look, it was a long time ago. It's not too relevant now, but Izzy said I should tell you the truth. I shouldn't have tainted our first meeting like that. What is that? A hacky sack? Can you throw this as far as where Anya's at? I don't know. You want me to try? Would you? River! Are you insane? Get away from there! I think this memory isn't too far from the last. Think they might be connected? Probably. Why did she cut her hair anyway? I like long hair. All right. Let's prepare the memento. That one was very straightforward. Oh, could I have looked at her again?
Such tiny jumps in time.
This was a very important time, it would seem. Everyone with it is different, John. Just because she and I share the syndrome doesn't mean we share the same head. But you must be able to help somehow. Everything was okay at first, but now she's even more aloof than before. Even when we're in the same room, she's never really there. It's starting to take a toll on me.
I just don't know how to take it anymore. Well, I can't speak for her, but many of us do long for connections. Though, being able to articulate it is a different story. Just because she struggles to express it, it doesn't mean she doesn't feel anything. She's still there, right? Sometimes you just have to have faith that she cares. It's pretty difficult to do day in and day out. I know. Wait, but why do you seem so normal, Izzy? I mean, don't you have the same condition? For one, I was diagnosed when I was still young. With effort, it's not impossible to acquire a guise of social norms systematically. But you know what? I both envy and pity River. Me, I'm an actress because I've been doing it all my life. Not only on stage, but off stage, and at practically every moment. I've gotten good at it because acting is the only option I have. It's the only way for me to be normal. But River, she never did that. She remained an outcast and refused to learn to step against it. I don't know if it was by choice or by limit, whether by bravery or cowardice. There are days when I just can't stand faking it anymore. And then I realize that it's too late. The Isabel that people know of is all an act, and the real me has long become a stranger. I think in the end, I just envy her. Huh. I've never met a woman with it before. Then, technically, you still haven't met one. This isn't part of our business. Let's move. I think this is going to be part of the business. I don't know much about brain disorders. The world would be a lot more beautiful if people just remembered faces more. Huh. All these people are ghosts because nobody just remembers passing strangers. Anything new today? No. What are you reading there? The Emperor's New Clothes. I loved this when I was young. Still do, huh? Of course. Just for different reasons. When I was a kid, I loved the Animorphs series. God, that's so dated now. I know, your mother gave you a book from it as a wedding present. Yeah, that was one odd wedding present. I guess I was pretty obsessed with it when I was a kid. Why haven't you read them since? I saw them. They're collecting dust in the garage. Well, I just grew out of them, I guess. I mean, they're children's books. What's wrong with reading children's books? They're comforting. I suppose so. I think I'm going to get this one.
Michelle, really fast, please look at this.
That's a lot of pieces.
I don't know what happened.
You just got like an entire weapon right there.
Yes.
He's playing Terra. I'm not yours, you're not mine, be my anti-Valentine. Hey, River, this one's not that corny. River? But what about David's? He's my favorite character. I don't know. What are you talking about? Animorphs, have you read it? No. Yes. Really? Sort of. Oh, do you know what animal is David's main morph? Oh my god, which one was David? What did he like?
What was he working to? Was he the hawk? The falcon?
No. That was Tobias.
Oh.
God, I remember that.
You clearly remember more about this than I do.
Oh, only teeny tiny bits. I'm gonna say Tiger. Tiger. Okay. That doesn't sound right. Don't worry, I'll find it out for you. No!
What?
Well, if it's five letters, what is it if it's not Tiger? I don't think it was Wolf.
No. Eagle?
I'll try it. All right. Sky, I need to know.
You need to know? Do you need me to look this up for you?
Maybe. Otherwise, I'm gonna keep trying.
Okay.
Which one was David? I feel like David was the main character. I don't know what it was. It's not Eagle, it's not Tiger, probably not Wolf. Because Wolf doesn't have enough letters. Oh, delete. Fine, okay. This is important to me now. Get dust on my camera.
Okay, so apparently the actual correct answer is lion. What they want is cobra.
Cobra?
He apparently also morphed into a rattlesnake, not a cobra. I specifically found it in relation to this game.
Oh yeah, a cobra! I really wish they kept the old covers instead of these plain sheets. Those were cool. Alright, so Sky looked it up for me because this was important to me. But that's not the right answer.
Yeah, it should have been lion.
He says it should have been lion, and that he did transform into a rattlesnake at one point.
Yeah, he also transformed at into some a rattlesnake, point. But...
But it wasn't his main one. Yeah. I just remember one of the girls transforming into an alligator and then finding out she was allergic to it. And then it, like, screwed with her powers, and then actually, like, an alligator just kind of popped out of her on, like a TV studio set. I remember this.
There is the,
Oh, so I was supposed to come over here.
But apparently...
So I was supposed to come over here and ask...
Yeah, ask her.
River.
Apparently, River says something like, you could have Googled it, and people are like, yeah, but...
Tobias Hawk, Rachel Grizzly, Jake Tiger, Marco Gorilla, David Cobra, Cassie Wolf. Oh, I was thinking of Jake. Who is David?
Apparently he was Lion.
Who is David? I remember everyone but David right now. Because Tobias turns into the hawk, Rachel's in love with Tobias.
David is a villain from the Animorph series.
He's
a teenager who unknowingly handed his family to the parasitic aliens known as the Yerks, and was forced to become one of the Animorphs, but ended up becoming one of their worst enemies.
That must have happened after I stopped reading.
He appears in what is known as the David Trilogy, consisting... in book 20, 21, and 22.
God, do I...
He later reappears in book 40.
Did they get him trapped in an animal form?
Eight?
Did they trap him in an animal form? I also remember one of their specials, their side books. They went, like, back in time to dinosaurs.
So he had a pet cobra, but lion is his big thing.
Did he get trapped as a morph, though?
He favored lion and golden eagle.
I'm not asking what he favored. Did he get trapped at one point? Did they get him stuck as an animal?
I don't know.
Oh, just wondering. You could have just Googled it.
I don't see what...
Perhaps I should reread them after all. I can barely recall a thing from that series.
I do remember one of them fighting the other ones as a golden eagle, though. So I think I must have read some of it.
Okay, so I've got all five, so now I'm trying to find... the key. That ended up having a lot of books, didn't it?
Well, seeing as how he returns in book 48, I would say yes.
Yep. Yeah, I never saw the TV series. I don't think it would hold up well. I don't want to watch it now. I never had cable. What am I missing here? So I can talk to them, and I can talk to him. I can't talk to anyone else. Oh, here we go. There we go. Whether she kills him or not has never been established. Oh my goodness. All right. Ideal. I am finding it ridiculous that Animorphs is coming up here.
Now you're going to go back and read Animorphs.
I don't know. I think I would find it too cheesy now. Also, there's so many.
Yes, they're probably really fast reads.
Probably. Aw, everyone's leaving already? But I just got here. Seems to happen to you a lot at parties. Oh, go and save your childish jabs for the insecure. Look at Animorphs, Johnny's favorite childhood books. Makes me feel so old. Alright, I've got a book on the table. An aged Animorphs book. Where are we now? Oh, maybe they're getting married now? Glass of pickled olives. I see Le Fromage, but where's the mouse? That's the corniest remark you've made all night. Don't you mean cheesiest remark? Oh, wow. Tables. Nope, nothing down there. Let's go back this way. I
I bet they're at the lighthouse again, or looking at the lighthouse again. One of these things. In the lighthouse we go. Do you feel any different? Now that we got the rings on, I mean. No. Why, do you? Actually, yeah, I think so. What is it like? It's just different. Just the responsibilities, I suppose. Responsibilities. Do you like the name Anya? Would you like to name her Anya? I understand. I'm glad he understands, because I don't. Yeah, Anya's a good name for her. Hey, come with me. So she has yellow and blue flowers in her hair, and she's wearing the yellow and blue dress. And she made a yellow and blue paper rabbit. And also a plain yellow paper rabbit. This can't be a good idea. I'll probably trip and fall. Don't worry, just follow my steps. Oh, my ass. I think you stepped on my toes. Sorry. Come on, let's try again. And they danced the night away. So sweet. To promise, to love and comfort, to honor and to keep in sickness and in health for as long as you shall live? I do. And do you take this man standing before you to be your lawfully wedded husband? To promise to love and comfort, to honor and to keep in sickness and in health for as long as you shall live? Yes. By the power invested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Wiles.
Oh, excuse me.
Heck, the wedding. Yeah, what did you think that was? I'm just bad at weddings, that's all. Fluids tend to escape from my eyes. I didn't know you were that sentimental. Oh, did I say my eyes? I meant my mouth. And by fluids, I meant both fluids and solids. That's a lovely image. Thanks, Neil. Come, let's find a way to get out of here. All this happiness and joy is really putting you off too, huh? No, I just don't like watching people make mistakes. Sheesh, whatever happened to just take it moment by moment?
Oh, we'd better go see how your aunt is doing. All right, Ma. Tell her thanks for coming.
I will.
I'm so proud of you, Joey.
Joey? Oh, that's my grandpa's name. He passed away before I was born. Ma calls me by it as my nickname.
How come you never told me about it?
Because I'd rather you call me John.
Not another sentimental grandparent childhood.
What do you have against those anyway? I mean, you sure talk about your grandfather a lot.
What? No, I don't.
Whatever you say.
Joey. Johnny's nickname named after his grandfather.
Alright, here we go.
I'm so proud of Joey.
That's all you're gonna say? Okay. So I need one more. Here we go.
I'm sure one day I'll commit to doing voices, but right now, super embarrassed. So I'm just gonna keep doing what I'm doing.
Oh, did someone run over a rabbit?
Can't be helped, River. I'm sure they didn't mean to.
Come on, we're late.
Wait, is that a rabbit? Think this is the source of all those folded paper ones?
Why would she obsess over some roadkill? Not to mention so many years later.
Don't ask me, you are the woman here.
I'll be convinced that I'm the only one when you do a cordless bungee jump.
He's having chunks.
Come on, River, we're late.
Received note, dead rabbit.
I have not received this note. There it is. Roadkill on Johnny and River's wedding day.
I'll be honest. Most brides on their wedding day, unless that's their pet rabbit, they are too busy to really notice that. Most traditional brides. For people who go more low-key, I'm sure they have the time to notice that, but for the most part, no! You're running around like a ninny for the whole day. You don't have time to stop and stare at a dead rabbit in the road. Sad as that is.
You know it's a fantastic wedding when the memento is roadkill.
Hey, maybe she saw it as a metaphor for the terrible marriage. So years later, she began folding the rabbits because she was reminded of how rotten it was. Or, you know, something equally pretentious.
Cool story, Neil.
It's not to say that seeing dead animals in the road doesn't break my heart every single time. Just can't really obsess over it. Poor thing. What's with all the road kills today? Don't you look at me like that. It smells like a farm. And roadkill. Deactivate the scent simulator or get away from here already. Go over the wall. Here we go. Bye.
Hey.
Babies. Whoa. Don't do it. Don't do what? You know what? Don't not ride this horse? What are you, 5 years old? Okay, I won't not ride it. Yeah! Quit wasting time, Neil. Oh, crap! That can't be good. Ah, do something! Don't just stand there! Help me! Damn it, this was not in the job description. Notes. Village idiot. Yep. Let's see, he went galloping off this way, right? Oh, look who we have here. Is that really a good idea? She should be okay. She's not new to this anymore. But she's never done it by herself before. I'll be fine. I'm not a child. Ah! Ah! River! It's like me on a horse.
Don't think it likes me!
This is less like me on a horse. What's the matter? Let's go! Hey, wait up! Huh, I wonder if Neil got off that horse yet. Yeah! And that was Eva! This is about 19% more than I can handle! What a moron. Oh, what the corn cob. Move. I'm bad at galloping, so I'm just gonna go for it, I think. I keep running into trees. I saw movement up this way. Do I have to catch him? I am never going to catch him. Damn it. Stop! Stop! Fine! Screw you! Oh my. Where'd all the rocky cliffs go? Oh, I found the wrong person. Ha! Punted him! Thanks! Ow. Got her. I've got one more I need to get. Stop running into trees, me! Alright, memento detected, but I don't have them all yet. Nope, don't run over the rabbit. I must still be missing one. I wouldn't show me. How do I get off the horse? There we go. Here, this memento will do. But I'm not getting on that horse again. You go get the rest of the memory links. Yeah, I got him. Prepare the memento! Activate the memento! Alright. So this is when they're still dating. Is the diagnosis certain? Yes. We've reached a consensus on the results. Unfortunately, like many cases of pervasive developmental disorders, this is a rather late diagnosis. Had you known when you were a child, miss, it could have saved you a lot of trouble. Do you have any books on it? This one is by Tony Atwood. He's one of the specialists on the subject. You can borrow it free of charge for now. Just don't elope with it. Thanks, Doc. I am getting good at the puzzles. Now I'll do horrible at the next one. Now, are you two a couple? Unmarried and without any other current legal affiliation. Yes, I see. Well, I could give you a referral to a specialized counselor if you wish. Is there anything unsettling in the relationship? No. And you, sir? No. It's fine. Nonetheless, sir, you should also give the book a read. It'd help you understand her condition. I'd rather not. Why is that? Well, it's your call. In the meantime, there is a thing called equine therapy that might help her. A ranch just north of here offers it. I can contact them for you. Told you so. So, pervasive developmental disorder. Is this about autism? I found it. Excuse me, could you help me? Could you please silence the clock? The ticking really bothers her. It's not that severe. I'll be okay. No problem. It's standard policy. If there's anything at all that makes you uncomfortable, just let me know. Thank you. Huh. I guess that explains the ones in the house. Clock ticking. Something River can't stand. A stuffed toy platypus. I can't believe this piece of atrocity is dated all the way back here. Looks like someone took good care of it. She's still got pretty bad taste in animals, though. Just a bit longer. They'll be calling for you soon. Note, Tony Atwood. The author of a series of books on River's condition. Dr. Neil Watts, a pretty cool guy. He changed the note. Plain tawny handbag. Let's prepare the memento. We're getting close to figuring out what's going on, I think. Ha ha ha! Did it again. I'm fabulous. So I'll fail horribly on the next one then. Oh, we're in childhood now.
Psst, look! I know!
I can't believe he once paid to see this crap in the theater!
No, you idiot. Look, we leaped.
Holy overcooked macaroni! The kid's in the theater all by himself! What a loser! You go to the theater by yourself all the time. That's different. No one's competent enough to match my taste. But that aside, how could anyone last through this rubbish? Was he waiting for someone? And thus, this movie sucks on both physical and metaphysical levels. QED. Come on, let's go. What? Oh, right. Whoa, wait, I ain't talking to no emo teenager. Grammar, my dear Watson. Shut up, it's not even a full sentence. Let's just go look for mementos. I still ain't talking to no emo teenager. Here. What are you doing? That's the third person you've removed here. Not like it's permanent. So I'm just removing people. Why am I removing people? Getting stood up? Now that's a Kodak moment. You relate well with your kin, I see. I'm gonna wander around a bit first, and then I'll try to get rid of all the people to see if that triggers something. Alright, I don't see anything else. I'm just gonna... I haven't been able to do this before. Well, there's nothing here. Hate to say it, but I guess I have to nag something out of him again. All yours! At least there's no olives this time.
Oh, it smells like food. River? You were in there this whole time? I waited for you at the lobby. I thought you didn't come. Why did you leave? I thought we were watching the movie together. Huh? I'm the one who should ask that. What do you mean? We were watching the movie together, and then you left. We weren't watching it together. I didn't even know you were where you were. If you saw me in there, why didn't you come and find me? What difference does it make? We were watching the same movie in the same room. What's wrong? You're so weird. Do you not want to watch the movie together anymore? Of course I do. Come, let's head back in before it ends. I feel like I should make a clever remark. You feel wrong. Well, let's hope our ride's waiting for us in there. There's that platypus again. Nope. Let's prepare the memento. I sort of already done the platypus. Did it again. Nope. Let's activate. You know, I think this platypus is growing on me. Mostly just for convenience, but hey! Now I just took another tiny jump.
Smell like food.
I know. Come on, dude. Grow some balls. It's not that. Look, maybe this wasn't such a good idea. Oh, sheesh. What could possibly happen? Just think about it. Worst case scenario, she says no. You strut on like nothing happened, no one will know, and everyone will still think you're cool. But what if she tells someone? Or yells at me? Don't be a little wuss! Or says yes, but really means no. Shh, quit worrying. Who would do that? And what if she throws an encyclopedia in my face? I don't even have a helmet! Dear Lord, I am so not prepared for this. Dude, don't panic. Just straighten your spine and quit being a little wuss. Yeah, you tell him! Everything will be all right. Just turn around. Okay? Okay. Hey, what are you... Shh! Ahem. Hello? Hello? Can you hear me? Yes? Then why didn't you... Never mind. That's a cool platypus you got there. What are you reading? A book. About platypus? No. Oh, I think that's great.
He's laughing over here. Hey, you want to get lighthouses? Huh? There are exactly 16 second-order Fresnel lens lighthouses in the country left. 9 of them are coastal, and 1 of them was modified from a historic kerosene lamp lighthouse. Oh, is that what you're reading about? No. Say, you want to go catch a movie together sometime? I don't know. That's okay, I'll give you time to consider it. I can't. Why? There's no date or time. Oh, how about this Saturday at 8? Well? Eva, I think the system froze. Yes. Oh, great! Never mind. I guess we'll work out the details later? I'll just... What? What are you looking at me for? You think I'm going to call out how utterly awkward that was? Well, just forget it. I'm not giving in to your expectations. Give him a break. He was still just a kid. You of all people should relate. What's that supposed to mean? Shut up and go. Shut up isn't my name, you know. Stuffed toy platypus. Well, I suppose if you look at it from the right angle... No, not really. Never mind. What the heck were you doing in there, dude? What? I asked her out. No, that was pathetic. If I were you, I'd have just barged in there and be all like, hey, you, go out, me, you, now. Yeah, like that ever works.
Isn't that exactly how I asked you out?
No. No, it's not. You were a gentleman.
Really? I thought that was it.
Yes, you just barged in the room and said, you, me, date, now.
Yeah. That's how I remember it.
Lucky for you, I remember it better. That's just terrible. I know, and it would have still been better than what you just did. So did she throw an encyclopedia in your face? Huh? Did she? Shut up, dude. See, I'm not the only one who tells people to shut up. And suddenly, I feel loved. Dear Lord, I can't believe you got me to take this stupid class. Aw, come on, it's fun. Only if you can paint. You'll get good if you practice, you know. Yeah, right. After this class, I'm never picking up a brush again. Never say never. Quit complaining. I'm sure you'll learn to enjoy it someday. What's around this room? Leonardo da Vinci trained by drawing eggs. Barrels are like very big eggs. Therefore, you will all be very big da Vincis. What?
Sounds like a bullshit teacher to me.
What else is around here? Anyone? Anyone at all? All right then. River, why don't you answer it? I know you know the answer. We're waiting, River.
is a jerk teacher right here.
Fine, I guess we'll have to. He made sail on August 3rd of 1492 from the Spanish city of Palos de la Frontera, which was founded in 1322 and granted to Alvar Perez de Guzman, who was at the mere age of 14 by the... Okay, only asked for the date. But see, was that so hard? Good lord, does everyone with her condition have near photographic memory? Not really, though I think their rote memory is often fairly strong. She's coming this way. Alt-tab! Save note, Alt-tab. Lifesaver. Alt-F4! Alright. Looks like nothing else of note is happening here. We do have a door we can go through here. Locked! Only open during lunch hours. That's a wrap! You chumps better be, better next time. An atrium. We could use this place later. I just can't believe that these court lines are rectangles in his head. Fine, you win. Booyah! Now is it lunchtime? Saw a bunch of kids running. Yep, it's lunchtime. Yeah, she's unique, but she's uniquely boring. I mean, just look at her! She just sits there by herself all day with that creepy deformed duck toy. It's not a deformed duck, it's a platypus. The heck's a platypus? Quit making words up. Anyway, she's just so off, you know? It's like she's from a totally different planet or something. I know, isn't that cool? If you're into aliens and that sort of stuff, I guess. But really, if you want to be weird, why don't you just go hang with the emos and goths? Well, for one, I don't want to ruin my hair. The fact that we got a name for them says a lot, too. Look, Nick, I just don't want to be another typical kid in a sea of typical people. But how the heck would being with her change your own identity? I mean, you'd just be some guy who hangs out with a shy girl. She's not just shy, Nick. There's something strange about her. Being strange isn't always a good thing, you know. Do you even know if she wants to be different? Maybe she just wants to fit in like everyone else. And if she does, pushing her the other way wouldn't help, would it? Look, Nick, the point is that I know what I need. Yeah, teenagers totally know what they need. And she's the one who has it. So you want her for what she has, but not for her? That's cold, man. I just hope you know what you're doing. I do. No, he doesn't. He's a teenager. Sorry for all teenagers out there, but you don't know what you want. You'll understand when you're older. No. I think you're wrong, though. People aren't that typical. Everyone's unique in some way. That's just what grandmas tell you.
Wait, so this guy's some kind of human-hogging hipster? That's sort of disturbing. You know, sometimes I want to slap our clients upside the head. It's high school. Everyone's a bastard. But hey, welcome to the club. Wait, so this is what he told her about at the cliff? I suppose so. She then went cuckoo and began to make those creepy rabbits, right? Because he confessed this from who knows how long ago? I guess she's pretty good at holding a grudge. I'm not buying it. Something feels missing. Then go get a hat, Sherlock. Come on, I think our passport's leaning against the table there. I'm envious that this kid was still there to help him move pianos when their hair grew white. I wish I was still in contact with my childhood friends. And to be honest, when I was a teenager, I thought I wanted to go to art school. That was not a good idea. Didn't know what I wanted then. Still don't really know what I want now. That's life. Reasons and intents aside, it's pretty remarkable that they actually met in high school. How many of those go on for more than a month nowadays, huh? I don't know about you, but mine went pretty swimmingly. Yeah? So swimmingly, it swam right out the window. Sounds about right. Stuffed toy platypus. I just love how every time we see this thing, we're guaranteed a free memory link. Must have left as big a scar on his mind as it did on mine. On his mind as it did on mine. Should I even? No need, I'm all good now. Kamei! Oh, for walnut's sake. Kamei! Hey! Not cool, Eva. You never... I'm guessing cockwalk someone in the middle of a Kamehameha. What? Prepare the memento. Let's try the diagonal again. Diagonal is usually a pretty good bet. Wahahaha! I am ideal once more. All right. Shanks is just passed out over there, isn't he?
He is.
All right. Oh, he's a kid now. I'm more of a kid. Or I guess this is how big he was before, huh? Yeah, he's still a teenager. Going to school now, Ma. Have a nice day, Joey. My baby boy, growing up so fast. Ugh, what if he was a girl? Would she still nickname him after his grandpa? It wouldn't be that bad, actually, since it ends in an A. E. Joey, Jewy, Julie. Sounds cute. If it sounds so cute, why don't you marry him? Aw, jealous. Oh yes, so jealous. Well, to be fair, a ticking clock is pretty annoying. There's olives. Oh, blood, not again. A glass bottle of pickled cucumbers. Holy crap, my mind's totally blown. You're pretty easily impressed. Okay. found the memento. Now, what am I missing? Already set. Oh, there's an upstairs. There is an upstairs. Animorphs. Various books with smudged titles. Prepare the memento. Here's where I screw it all up. Or not. Alright. Let's activate the soccer ball. That was a quick one. And now there's nothing. Ugh, it smells like roadkill again. Where are we? Eva? The hell is that? Storm's rolling in. That's his next memory. Yeah, but why is it going Laputa on us? I don't know. It's just not linking the memories together for construction. There must be a malfunction within the machine's ADG. Again? I thought the last fix was foolproof for another half a year. I can't believe those idiots in the maintenance department. Look, don't worry. We've already gotten the teenage years saved. We might still be able to do this. Alright, but I ain't telling him about this. As long as we succeed, he doesn't have to know. Well, I guess this is it. There's nothing we can do here. Ready to finalize before activation? Ladies first. What a shame. I was actually looking forward to it. I wonder what we missed. Act 2. Billions of lighthouses stuck at the far end of the sky. So it is 9 o'clock. I think that this might be where we end. We'll get through this intro scene right here, whatever's happening right now. They can't stop it anyway. Don't disturb them. They might not wake easily, but they need the concentration. I already forgot what this act was called. Damn my memory. And that's all this old fool knows. Sorry, I can't be of more help. Then that'll have to be enough. All that's left to do is linking your registered desire to go to the moon with your early memories. Then we'll pull the switch and voila! You'll be on the moon in no time. I have a question. If you could make Lily disappear, that means you can alter this world. Then, can you not simply make things happen and fulfill my wish here and now? That would work if this were one of your true set of memories. If this were your one true set of memories. What do you mean? What is this then? What am I? This is just a copy, a canvas for us to work with, if you will. As for you, you are merely an algorithm traced from Johnny. Enough to reflect his likeness, but far from complete. All we can do is prepare this canvas in a logically consistent way. And then, when we transfer your registered desire to your childhood, the machine will generate your new life, one where the desire dictates your behavior. The result of that would then be written to the real John. So, you see, even if we satisfy you, you are merely a read-only program. I mean, we could reset you over and over again, and that's enough. Oh, don't be so sensitive. He's not real, you know. If you truly believed that, why did you even care to explain? I'm just trying to save time. Let's go. Doctor, is that what I truly am? Ah, it keeps going. Ah, all of our night's work. The dead rabbit. Why is he a floating head? What the? At least give me a warning first. What can I say? I like being a head. I'd ask if that's a pun, but I'm afraid you'd say yes. Let's do this fast. I feel silly enough in this form as it is. All we need to do is pass his desire from his latest memory to the earliest. Alright, I guess we'll get to the childhood then. Line up two matching mementos on the edges to transfer the registered desire. Okay, so we've got... There we go. This one's going to be the rabbit. Book. Hey, Eva, check this out. Nom. Seriously? Go. We're missing that link over there. Ding! That's about all the ones we can work with. Ready to pull the switch? You know me, always ready. Alright, let's go check out what souvenirs he brought back from the moon. Ladies first. Not this time, hun. Same setting as his real last accessible memory. Usually there's at least some change. Something isn't right. These memories, they feel more than just having happened again. They are exactly the same. That's impossible. The desire was transferred, was it not? It was. You guys, I can't stop, apparently. I guess I'll keep playing until dinner's ready?
Sounds good.
If this is indeed the same memory, he'd be at the cliff overlooking the lighthouse. Johnny? What a pleasant surprise. We don't get many visitors around here. Deja vu again. My name is Dr. Eva Rosaline, and this is... What? I'm not saying it twice. Dr. Neil Watts. Are you familiar with the Sigmund Agency of Life Generation? Is that dinner?
No, dinner should be in 20 minutes.
Okay. Oh, were you two from the agency? How convenient. I've just been thinking of calling you. Lily, get us some tea, please. Lily? Freeze him, too. Well? Wait here. I'll go send the desire signal again. See if there are any changes. It transferred successfully for sure. Any changes? Not even a hair. How could this be? Even if his desire doesn't work alone, why is there no change at all? Perhaps it just needs some provoking to activate. From his early memories? The earliest we can get to. Let's go. This guy is stubborn. Johnny's desire to go to the moon might need some stimulation to be brought up, huh? Well then... Moon! What the? This wasn't what they said was playing. Oh well. Do you mind, River? No, I like this one. Alright, let's go then. Hopefully that's enough for an ignition. Wait, where is Neil? Did you see To the Moon? How was it? It's a bit too much pretense for me. I prefer my movies to be a bit more... Oh, je ne sais quoi. Yeah. So basically it wasn't pretentious enough for that person. To the moon, darling. Ooh, Henry. Dear Lord, I'm way too tired and hungry to be constructing movies. Guess I should go see if anything's changed with John. Save. Sorry for making you sit through this, buddy. All the same. I'll have to try igniting it somewhere else then. This is ridiculous. Lily? I'm gonna screw with this guy's head, apparently. Perhaps something here could work. I don't have time for her right now.
What are you guys doing here? It's starting. Let's go get a good spot. Wait, I don't remember that happening. Something must have changed. Hey, don't squeeze. Wait a minute. This isn't a real change. This is... May I have your attention, please? As you know, I am a representative sent from NASA in all its glory. And I'm here to tell you all about it. Hit it, Timmy! Wow, that was terrible. But I digress. Anyways, I know that many of you are wondering, what chances do I have of doing something as awesome as adventuring in another realm? To inhale the sweetness of Venus, to swim counterclockwise through the rings of Saturn, or perhaps just chilling at the backside of the moon? Well, here at NASA, we believe that with enough will, everyone has the potential. It could be you. Or you. Or, perhaps, you! If I don't want to go to the moon, then you're in luck. Wait, what? Why not? Why should I? I'm happy here on Earth as it is. Well, don't you want to go there even a little bit? No. Why? Not even a tiny bit. No. Well, as an official NASA recruiter, I shall go over some facts about the moon. To start off, the moon is 4.5 billion years old. And did you know that its surface is about as big as Africa? It's true. In fact, if you try to bike around the moon... Also, it takes 1.5247 seconds for light to travel from the moon to here. And if you drive a flying car, it takes 130 days. I knew that. And last but not least, people who go to the moon get rich and famous. And we all know that rich plus famous equals groupies. So, that concludes my presentation. Remember, NASA welcomes any of you, especially if you're a brunette. Well, what did you think? NASA probably wouldn't hire you, but I suppose it was blatant enough for this. I do try pretty hard. Are you gonna go see if that worked? Of course. Be right back. Back. Report. Utter failure. Deuce. Hey, don't get discouraged. I'm sure there are still things to be done. Such as... Well, so the problem is they don't have any why for why he wants to go to the moon. He doesn't actually want to go to the moon, maybe. We can't afford to finish building this house, Isabel. We can barely afford to pay for her treatment. But you can afford the lunar trip lottery! But can you afford the lunar trip lottery? If you sell this house, you sure can! Is the diagnosis certain? Yes. In fact, we rarely have anyone... Did you know that NASA has excellent healthcare plans? It's true, for both you and your spouse. Oh, I guess that was the woman that time. Free pony rides in space! Oh look, a wedding! Good for you! But here's a riddle. Guess where you should go for the honeymoon? They're getting desperate now. River? Dag nabbit, glass, slippery. Johnny, John. What the cucumber? Whew. You know what? This just isn't working. It's more than just not working. It's ridiculous. We're freaking professionals. I didn't sign up for the job to run around yelling at him like an idiot. You didn't? Look, maybe this lack of sleep's getting to us. Had I known that we'd be an all-nighter, I would have brought coffee. I agree. You should have seen the movie I constructed earlier. What movie? Exactly. Anyway, as valuable as time is here, this just isn't going anywhere like this. Let's take a break till morning. Hopefully Johnny can hang on till then. I do have some calls to make. It doesn't make sense. Why did the machine have no effect? Johnny's registered wish to go to the moon was successfully transferred, yet there wasn't even a trace of him wanting to go to the moon after the transfer. Unless a secondary condition for the desire was changed in the process. Only then would the same desire produce two different outcomes at two different points in time? There's no denying that River played an important role through it all. If there's anything that could have caused the core to change, she would be the top suspect. But out of all things, what exactly caused it? River, just what exactly did you do? Ah, the sun's rising. We don't have much time left. I wonder if Neil came up with anything. Alright, so I still don't know what the deal is with the lighthouse, and I don't know what Anya, or what River has. You can smell it. Squirrel Neil ran over all the way from here now. Let's go downstairs. Oh, the rabbits everywhere. I can hear water. Is that because I stored the tap water earlier? The cabinet is filled with dusty books. Unused fine china. And this chest was locked. And this one is also locked, I believe. No, I understand that part, but... Okay, did you confirm it in his records?
And why again was this information not made available to us? Or the medical doctor, for that matter? Where'd you get that coffee? Shh! Are you speaking with the headquarter? Are you speaking with headquarter? Yes, I'll fill you in after. Now, shh! I thought I left this at Johnny's bed. Oh, yeah, where did you find that? I thought you shushed me. Temporarily unshushed. Oh, ain't I lucky. Well, I found the rabbit in the lighthouse last night. There are a bunch more of them there, and in the basement, too. Ah, All right, resume shushing. I guess let's go upstairs. A painting of a lighthouse by the cliffside with the moon. That must be important. Painting of a woman holding something yellow and blue. Painting of an animal of some sort, so that's the platypus. A casual painting of three people. So there's him, his friend, and somebody else. And then this is River with that bunny, I guess. How is John doing? Barely hanging on. What are you two doing? We just couldn't make any progress. You'd better be soon. We don't have long. If you're looking for your colleague, I think he's in the kitchen. Yep, I know that. Oh, this is yellow now. That's no good. I haven't tried the study yet. Yes. But Ma, I don't want to go to school. It's Sunday, dear. Shh, let them sleep. Turn it off, you giant doofus. Almost stepped on the paint. The Emperor's new clothes, read passage. And the colors of that beautiful fabric. I've never seen anything like it in my life. They all tried to conceal their disappointment at not being able to see the clothes. A child, however, who had no important role and could only see things as his eyes showed them to him, went up to the carriage. "But he hasn't got anything on," the child said. "Don't talk nonsense," his father reprimanded. But the boy's remark, which had been heard by the bystanders, was repeated over and over. Nope. Oh, there's disease. Like, what's going on up there?
Nope. Alright, I guess all I can do is go back to the kitchen, huh? Unless I'm supposed to go to the lighthouse? Oh, here we are. Let's talk to you. Those two shouldn't have stayed up that late, but I should have watched them. Well, it's not an everyday circumstance. I know, but I'm just so exhausted. I'm sure you are even more so. I really need to take a seat. If there's anything you wanted to ask, let me sit down first. Oh, was there something you wanted to ask? You know, it's pretty unusual for someone like you to work here. With two children and all, I mean. It's not that bad, really. There's a school bus that passes through here. But how did you even end up here? Well, a few years ago, my husband passed away. What happened? He was in the army. They were the last batch to be deployed overseas. Sorry to hear. I panicked. Our savings were low and the job market was grim. Johnny saw my ad and offered me this job. I accepted with gratitude. This place was peaceful, too. It helped me with my grieving. Doesn't the government issue grants to war widows to help them get back on their feet? They do, and eventually I received aid. But by then, Johnny was starting to have trouble on his own. He needed my help. Tommy and Sarah liked this place, too, and so we stayed. As for Johnny, he was glad as well. We're going to miss him. I think, deep down, he really wanted a family. So what are you going to tell them about John? I don't know. I'll probably make something up, but it's no use. Kids are smart nowadays. They'll figure it out. Might as well. It's the nature of life. There's nothing to hide. This is your full-time job, isn't it? What will you do when this is over? What else is there to do? Find a job in the city and live on, I suppose. It's a shame, though. I'm going to miss Johnny and this place. Maybe I'll come back to visit every once in a while. Oh, hey. Before Johnny fell unconscious, he told me that you two would probably be coming soon. He said that he probably wouldn't get the chance himself, but he wanted me to tell you thanks for him. So, thank you. Let's go visit my colleague again. What is it? It seems like our little Johnny here has some hidden records from the old days. Hidden records? Hidden medical records, to be exact.
Meat tap. I didn't do anything with the potatoes, though.
Oh, potatoes.
What did you want done with the potatoes?
The way that you used to... Do you do them the simple way with the olive oil and just in the oven?
Alright, that's gonna take a little while.
It's okay.
I guess I'll get them started, then.
I'm almost done.
Are you almost at the end of the game?
No, I'm just gonna find a stopping point.
Okay.
Apparently, during his youth, he was administered a large dose of enhanced beta blockers. And what luck! They tend to have this little side effect on a curious thing called memories. Beta blockers. Johnny didn't have a heart condition, did he? Apparently not. Which leads one to wonder if these side effects were intended to be merely just that to begin with. And in such a large amount. Its impact on his memories at the time of administration must have been significant. You think that's what kept us out of his earliest memories? Well, it's not the machine, I'll tell you that. The maintenance department yelled at me for scolding them. So what now? I was just given the reconfiguration frequencies that should get us past the blockers. And once we're in his childhood, it might finally be early enough to transfer his desire for it to work. Then what are we waiting for? But just one thing. Of course, there's always that one thing. In order to activate the new frequencies, we'll need a trigger. A trigger? Something that exists strongly in the bridging inaccessible memory. And we'll need to give it to John for him to stimulate his memory internally. But what do we know of that? We've only gotten a glimpse of his childhood memories. Even if we find a childhood photo or something, John's unconscious. Yeah, back to square one.
You know, this job hasn't been such a pain in the arse for me since Nora's case last year. Likewise. This is killing me. I'm going out to get some fresh air. So someone gave him medication specifically to kill his memories. Forgot my coffee. Beta blockers. A drug with the side effect of dampening memories by interfering with stress hormones. It smells! Quit barging in and out of doors. The roadkill, Eva, it smells! I know, it's your fault for running over it. What's going on? The children are still sleeping. Wait a minute. That last memory, the one we were stuck at. It was the same smell. What are you two talking about? The olfactory receptors are directly linked to the brain's limbic system, Lily. Don't you see what this means? What? He means that smell is arguably the most effective sense for memory recall. We can use it as a stimulant to bridge his childhood memories. And the best part, even though Johnny's unconscious, he's still susceptible. I think I'm missing something vital contextual. I'm missing some vital contextual info on this whole thing. All right, this is good. This is awesome. Now you just need to go fetch a piece of the roadkill. Yes, I'll just wait. Why should I fetch it? You're the one who ran over it. Exactly. I've already done my part. Oh, you miserable bastard. If it helps any, I have a pair of gloves you can borrow. They aren't really disposable gloves, but that'll probably change after this. Let's go pick up some dead squirrel. Once we get back into memory mode, then that's going to be our stopping point. There go squirrels. Huh. Deja vu. At least it stops smoking. Dead squirrel! The kind of things this job gets me into. It's not safe to just bring a piece of germ-infected roadkill like this. There's a valved container in the car. It'd at least make its odor controllable. Where are you going? I gotta go take a leak. What a mess. The crash shook everything up. Let's see. Ah, here it is. Valved container. Now to get some of that dirty roadkill. What's this? This. Painkillers? Ugh. Contained roadkill odor. Insurance bump's gonna be a pain.
swear there was something I could interact with here. Oh, hey! Did you get the roadkill? It's ready. Great! Go get it set up. I'll be right back. Neil? These painkillers, I think they're yours. Hey! May I ask why you're on them? I wasn't going to tell you, but... Oh, this is embarrassing. A few days ago, I walked into a concrete wall. You just walked into a wall. What can I say? I was in deep thought. You know how deeply I think. These are some rather strong pills, Neil. And it was a rather strong concrete wall. It was a match made in heaven, I say. Anyways, you got the roadkill, right? Let's hurry. John's dying back there. Neil, you aren't addicted, are you? Are you kidding me? I'd overdose before I'd sink to that level of contrived mess. So when we get to that exact point, I will send the signal. When I do, I want you to release the valve for about 3 seconds. Certainly. About time you showed up. Have you made sure the germs are sealed off? Fully sealed and filtered. Not like it had mattered to a dead man. You should know that Johnny's condition is deteriorating fast. This might be your last chance, you two. Whatever you do in there, good luck. Luck's the last thing we need. Act 3. They shine their lights at the other lighthouses and at me. Let's go. All right, you guys. Let's see here again. This is where we're going to be stopping for tonight. We are just at the beginning of Act 3, and it's time for dinner. Thank you so much for joining me. Now the lines are red. That's no good. Exit game. I bet it's not. But thank you so much for joining me. This has been Acts 1 and 2 of To the Moon. Thank you again to Bartosa for giving me the game. I am definitely enjoying it so far. Some of it has hit a little close to home. We'll see how it goes from now on. So I will be back tomorrow at, let's say, 1:30-ish. Depending on how I get my details done tonight. Working some more on Skye's Balthazar's Regalia helm. Hopefully, we got it shaped pretty much. Just need to do a bit of tweaking and then work on the details. And there will be no evening stream tomorrow night. I've got some family stuff to do. And gigantic cosplay is being moved to Friday night. So, yeah, you can follow me on Discord and Twitter. Links to those down below. And, oh, my mind's a mess right now. I think that's about it. I'll see you again tomorrow. Have a wonderful rest of your evening or morning or whatever time of day it is for you. I'll see you when I see you. Bye.